Hi everyone, my name is Wesley. Are you ready for today's Sunday service? Before we start, let us pray. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for such a beautiful Sunday afternoon. We are ready to sing and praise your name on high. We are excited to learn more about you, to read Bible and hear stories. In the name of Jesus we pray, Amen.
Yeah. Let's bow down our eye. Let's bow down our eye. I mean, let's close our eyes and bow down our head and pray. Father Lord, we thank you so much for such a lovely afternoon. And Father, this is our first time doing this Zoom live meeting for Children Church Online Sharing. Father, I pray that your presence be with us, O Lord. And throughout the Bible lesson, Lord, you will open up our eyes, our ears, and touch our hearts so that we're able to understand what you want to speak to us this afternoon. And Father, also commit those children and the teachers unto you. May they're able to get to know you through this online sharing, Father. In Jesus' name and pray, amen. Okay, I have a question here. So today's story is about a tabernacle. I think it's a bit of a very difficult word. So let me ask you a question. Have you ever wondered why our house built with a lot of rooms? 为什么我们的家有这么多房间? 每个房间是有它的 purpose 的,对吗? 你们可以 name我你的房间, your house have what room?
Living room.
Yes, okay, very good.
Bedroom,
yeah.
Study room.
Yes, of course. You have a study room for study. Very good. And then in your rooms, you have furnitures, right?
Yes.
Okay, what furnitures you have?
Sofa.
Sofa, okay. Sofa for what? To sit down, lie down, and watch TV, right? And then what you have?
Bed
to sleep. Okay, and then?
Table.
Yes, table to eat or to study. Very good. I'm so glad you responded me with English. I'm so glad. I'm so proud of you all. Okay, so today's Bible lesson is about a tabernacle. So do you know what is a tabernacle? So today we're going to learn about tabernacle. Tabernacle is actually back in the ancient times, where it's a movable tent. You know those camping, those tents? So those tabernacle is a tent where it's a meeting. It's built to as a meeting place for the Israelites to worship God. So today I'm going to show you a short video on how God instructed Moses to build the tabernacle. Wait lah.
On Mount Sinai, God gave his laws to Moses. God also gave him instructions for different things to build. First was a special tent called the tabernacle, or tent of meeting. There in the tabernacle, God promised to meet with his people. The tabernacle was divided into two rooms, the holy place and the most holy place. In the first room, the holy place, there was a special table for bread, a golden lampstand with seven candles, and an altar for burning nice-smelling incense. The second room, the most holy place, held the Ark of the Covenant. It was a special chest covered in gold. On top, it held statues of two angels, with wings facing each other. Inside the Ark, they placed the stone tablets of God's law. It was above the wings of the angels on the Ark that God promised to meet with his people. God also chose men to be priests who would work in the tabernacle. Priests lit the candles, placed the bread, and burned the incense in the tabernacle. The priests would do all these things in the holy place. But once a year, the high priest would enter the most holy place. The high priest would enter with the blood of a goat as an offering for the sin of the people. But for us now, Jesus has shed his blood on the cross for our sins. Because of Jesus, we no longer need the tabernacle to meet with God.
Okay. Does anyone understand what a tabernacle now is? What is a tabernacle? Can you see that in the video?
Take the black.
Okay. Tabernacle is actually like what we're living now in a house. It's like a building. So God instructed Moses to build a tabernacle so that they can go there and worship him and give the offerings to him. So in the tabernacle, there's a few things, okay? Let me share you one more screen. Okay, so this is the model of tabernacle in Israel. So in the tabernacle, there are a few things actually God instructed Moses to build, okay? So the first thing is, what do you saw? Okay, that is the camp. The camp is the tabernacle, okay? So in that camp, we have a few several things that God instructed Moses to build. So the first thing is the bronze altar. Do you saw the picture? The bronze altar?
Yes.
Okay. Do you know what this used for? The first picture, the bronze altar, is actually made from acacia wood and covered with bronze. Okay. So at each corner, there was a bronze horn and it had golden carrying handles. Okay. Actually, this bronze altar is to burn the offerings. Like, you know, they will offer the goat, they will offer the grains and then burn it in the altar. Okay. So the second picture, what is that?
Laver.
Laver. It's called as a laver. Okay. So, sorry, I think I'll show you another one, so that it's easier for me, for you to see. Okay, this is a real tabernacle that was built in Israel. It is like a display. It's actually they built exactly like what God had instructed Moses to build. So yeah, so this is the outer gate. So this is the bronze altar, the altar of sacrifice. So this is where the Israelites will bring their offerings, such as goats or grains, their best thing that they wanted to offer to God, and they will burn in this bronze altar. Okay. And then after the bronze altar, we will follow by the laver. This laver is like a wash basin. It's a wash basin for the priest. Actually, God will appoint some priests, just like our pastor, okay? They were called priests, but now we are called as pastor. So they will wash their hand and their feet on this laver before they serve God. So now we go into the inside the tent. Okay, before that, does anyone remember inside the tent they got two rooms, right? Who remember what is the name? What is the two rooms name? Anyone remember?
Holy room.
Holy place. And one more is?
Most holy place.
Most holy place. Who answered that? Who answered that? Anyway, great job. Yes, great job. Yes, one is holy place and one is most holy place. So inside the most holy place, there is three things, okay? The first thing I'm going to tell is the lamp. So there's a lampstand which is made from gold, also made from the acacia wood and then covered with gold. So this this lampstand is to light up the holy place area. And then followed by, there is a table of shewbread. So this table also made from acacia wood and also covered with gold. So in this table, there will be breads, there will be bowls, jugs, and cups. And then lastly, in the holy place, there's one more thing which is called the incense. It's an altar of incense that they will burn the incense on that place. So this burning will have a very pleasant smell. It smells very good. And lastly, we will go into the most holy place where not everyone can go into this place, most holy one. The highest priest can only go in and actually go in and have a conversation with God and talk to God and pray to God. So inside this is called the Ark of the Covenant, which is also made from acacia wood and covered in gold. And inside the Ark of Covenant, there will be two flat stones. Do you know what these two flat stones? Do you still remember? In previous week, we always talk about rules. We always talk about 10 commandments. Very good, Leslie. Yes. These two tablets is the 10 commandments. So they will place inside there. So this is the tabernacle where previously, back in the Bible, God instructed Moses to build according to his words. So now, let me share you another screen. Okay, now let's move into the Bible lesson. So why is the tabernacle important? So we have 2 points over here. First point is God wants to be with us. Why God wants to be with us?
Protect us.
Yes, God actually loves us so much. So he wants to be the center of our lives. He wants to protect us, and he doesn't want us to always do the wrong things. He wants to guide us back to the right direction. Okay, and the second point is we should offer what we can to God. So what do you think you can offer to our God?
Money.
Okay. Yes, we pay tithes and offering. And besides money, what can we offer to him?
Sheep.
Okay, that is back in the olden. Now let's talk about now. We can give tithes and offering. And one thing, the most important thing is time. You see, now we are actually offering our time to God because we join church online sharing. We listen to God's word. So this is what God wants us to do. He wants to build a very close relationship with us, just like how we build our relationship with our family, with our friends. So this is why in previous times the tabernacle is important so that God can be with them and they can offer their best to God so that they can honor him. And now we no longer have tabernacle, but we have church. So we, of course, now during COVID-19, we can't go to church. So now we have online sharing. So we are still offering our time for our God. Amen. So next slide will be Bible memory verse. If you have any journal with you, so feel free to jot it down. And today's Bible memory verse is in the book of Exodus, chapter 25, verse 8. The people must build a holy place for me, then I can live among them. So if you guys doesn't understand what is in Mandarin, if I'm not mistaken, 是叫出埃及第25章第8节。
今天 OK， 轮到我。 So 今天小朋友大家好，然后我想问小朋友一下，我不知道你们还有开学对不对？ 是吗？因为我不知道你们情况，有时候政府我们小学的有时候要叫开，没有叫开啊。想想一下，现在小朋友想一下，你们有没有很久没有见的朋友？
有，
有，
是不是？你们有没有心中有没有想现在想到哪一个好朋友？有没有？
有，
有是吗 ？OK， 好，今天我们分享一个故事，就是好朋友的故事来的。让我们先看一看一个影片，小小的影片。
嗨，小朋友，我是李安老师。今天要和大家分享的故事是好朋友。公鸡咕咕、小猪波波和小老鼠强强，他们三个是好朋友。他们三个一天到晚都待在一起，一起起床，一起冒险，一起吃东西，因为他们觉得好朋友总是要在一起的。可是睡觉的时间到了，那该怎么办呢？让我们一起去看一看吧。
好朋友，每天早上，公鸡咕咕要负责叫醒农庄里的动物，小老鼠强强和小猪波波都会在一旁帮忙，因为好朋友总是要相互帮忙的。然后，他们会骑上脚踏车，从农庄出发，一起在晨光里兜风。无论路多么颠簸，山多么陡峭，弯道多么曲折，所挖多么深，都阻挡不了他们。有一天，他们在村里的池塘边捉迷藏，小老鼠强强躲在芦苇丛林时，发现一艘旧船，他们三个便立下共同的志愿，要成为海盗，因为好朋友总是一起做决定的。小老鼠强强掌舵，公鸡咕咕张开翅膀扬起了帆，小猪波波充当软木塞堵住了船底的破洞。他们就这样在宽阔的水面上航行冒险。一天下来，他们觉得自己变得更大胆更勇敢了，他们征服了整个池塘。可是饥饿还是把他们赶回了岸上。本来他们想钓鱼吃，可是肚子咕噜咕噜叫得好大声，把鱼儿都吓跑了。他们只好去采樱桃，他们把采到的樱桃分着吃，一颗分给小老鼠强强，一颗分给公鸡咕咕，两颗分给小猪波波，就这样一直分下去。小老鼠强强没什么意见，不过公鸡咕咕觉得不公平，所以他又分到了所有的樱桃核。因为好朋友总是要公平对待的，他们吃了太多樱桃，所以全都闹肚子了，得在回家前先到草地上解决一下。当夕阳西下，影子拖得好长好长的时候，他们骑上脚踏车回家，在鸡舍后面水桶旁边，他们三个发誓要做一辈子朋友，因为好朋友是永不分离的。他们说，那天晚上，他们打算在小老鼠强强家来睡觉，可是公鸡咕咕被卡在洞口了，于是他们又决定到小猪波波家过夜。不过，小老鼠强强鼻子太敏感了，他不想睡在猪舍里。最后，公鸡咕咕提议到鸡舍的木杆上睡觉，可是木杆断了，他们只好互道晚安，各自回到自己的床上去。有时候，好朋友也不能一直在一起，他们说，可是他们在梦里又见面了，因为好朋友总是会出现在彼此的梦中。故事讲完了。
OK， 好，看看我们有看到对吗，小朋友？就是说我们有想到，因为现在的疫情当中，有时候我们每一次我们都会 怎么说，我们上课的时候都有朋友一起玩，有一起学习的，然后有一起分享食物吃的。但是呢，我们这故事我们看到，有时候我们好朋友也是不能常在一起的，对不对？对吗？但是汉佳我问到大家的话，就是说你们心目中有想到哪一个朋友的，其实这个时候呢，我们也可以就是说打个他，或者是需要帮忙的，我们可以借个机会我们就问候。虽然现在是 online 我们都看到大家，但是彼此的话我们就靠着这些关系呢，不能见面的时候我们也是可以保持联络的。然后看到这故事的时候，还有其实圣经里面有也是有一对好朋友，大家知道是谁吗？
不懂。
就是大卫跟约拿丹，大卫跟约拿丹就是这个，就是大卫呢，他其实那时候他还没有当王的时候呢，他就被扫罗王叫进宫廷里面，因为他打胜了那个哥利亚。然后呢，就是他就跟那个扫罗王的孩子就是约拿丹，扫罗王的孩子是约拿丹，所以他们两个就成了好朋友。这样子，来我们看一看这 slide 一下啊，让我们解释一下。这个就是OK， 这个就是约拿丹呐、啊。然后约拿丹呢，他是扫罗王的孩子来的，所以他也是这个约拿丹也是以色列的战士哦，也是出来跟爸爸一起也是打仗的人。然后就看到还有一个就是大卫，看到没有？大卫年轻的时候他是什么？他就是看守羊群的哦，看守羊群。他还没有当王的时候，他是看守羊群的。然后呢，有一天呢，就是他打败了那个哥利亚巨人，哥利亚大家记得吗？巨人哥利亚。所以呢，他就派到皇宫里面去，然后帮忙扫罗王哦，见到了没有？见到了扫罗王，然后因此他就认识了扫罗王的孩子，什么名字啊？就是约拿丹。OK， 然后当时候呢，这个大卫呢，他就每次打仗的时候哦，他是每次很成功的，都是打胜仗的。当他打胜仗的时候呢，看到没有？他每次打仗他都打胜仗的。那打胜仗的时候呢，慢慢的那个扫罗王就很生气，很妒忌了。为什么呢？就是因为我一个我的仆人他还有本事过我会打胜仗，这样子他慢慢的他的心里呢就很生气很生气，然后又很妒忌，他开始呢就要伤害这个大卫了。他开始要伤害大卫哦，看到没有？他就跟他的孩子说，跟他仆人说，不要跟大卫做朋友，不要跟大卫做朋友。这样子的话，约拿丹怎样呢？也是很伤心的，我相信他也是很伤心的。他就去告诉他的大朋友大卫，我的爸爸的计划是怎样，说他警告大卫这样子。但 OK， 过后呢，他就慢慢的又来多一次，每次都是这样子，又打胜仗的时候，这个扫罗王又很妒忌。开始生气了，他开始生气了一个程度的时候呢，他说我要杀掉大卫，我要杀掉大卫，糟糕了，怎么办？然后他的孩子呢，那个约拿丹呢，就再次劝他的爸爸不要啦，不要杀害他，不要杀害他。可是爸爸还是不听，还是要杀害他，怎么办？所以没有办法咯，变成呢大卫就一定要逃亡了咯，对对，他要逃离开这个地方。但离开的时候呢，就是大卫有一次，就是大卫跟那个约拿丹最后一次见面了。他们最后一次见面的时候呢，就很伤心，很伤心，因为他们知道他们离开了，不知道几时会再见面。但是呢，这个约拿丹呢，还是祝福这个大卫平平安安能够离开，然后在上帝的面前呢，就立了一个约，做永远的好朋友，为他送上祝福。看到没有，小朋友？所以呢好朋友也未必永远会在一起的。有时候我们现在呢我们无论是上小学啊，上到中学，或者是长大的时候呢，我们还是永远有一个我们的很好的朋友，然后都能够是大家都能够彼此相连的。现在我们不能见到我们的朋友的时候呢，我们可以为朋友 有需要的时候我们可以小像约拿单这样子，朋友有困难的时候他也帮助他，他也为他祷告，这样子鼓励小朋友，当我们想到我们的朋友需要帮助的时候，当我们心中刚才我问了的有想到他的时候，我们也可以为他做祷告哦，无论是什么事情也好，我们也是要赞美主，我们有这样子的朋友曾经跟我们在一起过，帮助过我们。那如果我们有机会重逢的时候呢，我们更加珍惜这个友谊，因为上帝创造我们呢就是要与人和好，要爱我们的邻舍，爱我们的朋友啊，大家清楚吗？所以圣经里面有一对好朋友，就是约拿丹跟这个大卫哦，就是因为我们都知道，我们记得他的约拿丹他是扫罗王的孩子来的啊，大卫就是他的好朋友，但是自己的爸爸要伤害自己的朋友，所以就有时候也很无奈，很没有办法。可是他们也是彼此心中都是有大家跟彼此一起鼓励一起有祝福，在上帝的面前呢许下愿，我们做永远的好朋友，都会彼此祝福的，相信有一天他们也会重逢，好不好？小朋友，这样子我们都多多可以跟朋友保持良好的关系，跟鼓励大家可以为朋友祷告，这个是上帝所喜欢的。 OK， 我的分享就到这里。
Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for your words today. Thank you for the things we have learned, experienced, and discovered through this day. Thank you that you're always there to provide what we need and your daily protection no matter where we are. Help us to remember to seek your help, follow your ways, and walk in them with all our heart, our soul, our mind, and our strength. God, please forgive us for all our sins and help us to forgive others too. We trust in you, Lord Jesus, that we know you have a great plan for us in our life. We pray in Jesus' precious name. Amen.